Thanks, Matt. Afternoon, everyone. Thanks for joining us. As you know by now, Cricket Australia Board made three significant decisions yesterday, and I'm here today with Pat to talk to you about those, give you a little bit of background. The three decisions were to terminate Mickey Arthur's contract as coach of the Australian men's team. Secondly, to replace him with Darren Lehman as the new coach of the team. And thirdly, following a request from Michael Clarke to allow Michael to stand down as a selector of the Australian team. So I'd like to just talk briefly about each one of those for a moment, and then Pat and I are happy to take questions. The obvious question is why? Why make this change? I think the simple thing in answer to that right now is that the performances of the Australian team over recent months have not been at the standard that we expect or desire. As simple as that. But a little bit more deeply, I suppose, just to comment on some of the key ingredients that we see as important to a successful, high-performing team. Consistency of behaviour, accountability for performance, discipline. They're things that we would like to see in a team that's improving performance and continuing to build. We've recognised issues or concerns about that in months gone by, and in recent times we haven't seen the improvement there that we would like. The coach is not solely responsible for that, but ultimately we've made a decision that we believe will make a difference in this area. Why now? Why 3 weeks out from an Ashes series do we make this decision? I guess over recent weeks, when we've had a really close look at this, we've decided that things weren't improving. We've come to a conclusion that things weren't improving, and we could let things be as they are to stay with the status quo, or we could make change. And we didn't want to get to a stage where we look back on this Ashes series and felt that we could have done something about it. We've made a decision. There will be people that think that the timing is wrong, but we're very confident that this is a decision in the interest of the Australian cricket team, and a decision that we'll see improved performance from the Australian cricket team. I'd like to acknowledge Mickey Arthur and his commitment and dedication to the task and passion for the job of being coach of the Australian cricket team. Mickey Arthur is a good man. He's tried his utmost to do a good job, and unfortunately, at the end of the day, he just hasn't quite done that. We all have a very high regard for Mickey. A lot of people in the team are very close to him, and that friendship with him will continue. Darren Lehman is, to us, the obvious choice to come in and replace Mickey. As a cricketer and a coach, he has an outstanding record. He is very highly regarded within cricket circles, and he's certainly highly regarded within the Australian cricket team. His performances recently as a coach of Queensland and the Brisbane Heat have seen him win titles in all three formats of the game. And I think we've recognised that recently by giving him opportunities, development opportunities as a coach, and most recently being an assistant coach to the Australian A team here in England over the last few weeks. His performances over that time have been very impressive, and by being here now and ready to come into the role, we're confident that he will be able to take a running start at this job. Finally, the Michael Clarke decision, that's something that Michael has raised with us in recent times, a concern for him, and in raising that and discussing that at board level, we felt with the changes that we were making in the coach, now it was an appropriate time for us to review that and allow Michael to really focus on working closely with Darren and at the same time to allow him the best possible preparation both for himself and obviously his team. We've made a tough decision, and the timing of this decision will no doubt have surprised and indeed shocked a lot of people. It's not a decision that we've taken lightly. But the baggy green cap is something that is important to all Australian cricketers. It's something that it's one of the great prizes in Australian sport. And what we feel is that that Australian cricket fans expect that through great history and tradition of the baggy green cap, that there is a responsibility for performance. We're really confident that we are making the right decision right now. We are really confident that this Australian cricket team will respond positively under Darren Lehman. They will take responsibility for their performance, and we will see an effort during this Ashes series and going forward that all Australian cricket fans can be very proud of. Thank you.
Can I just ask for hands to be raised, please, and can you also give your name and organisation?
James, please, also from The Age. Did the handling of the David Warner incident
deal with the other fate? I wouldn't bring it down to one particular issue. As I said, we have over time had some concerns, and if you look back to India, we had expectations that things were on the improve there. That certainly wasn't the only issue that we were aware of that we had concerns of, but obviously that was more. A more public issue, and it gave further light to Pat and I doing some further investigations to get satisfied that we were making the right recommendation to the board for change.
Yeah, James Brady from Cricket Info. You said previously that you were disappointed that team management, coaches, etc., had let things get out of hand on a disciplinary culture level. Do you think a level up, you yourself let things get out of hand in terms of looking at the
way things go? Look, I think we all need to take responsibility for ultimately performance. You know, one of the key objectives as an organisation is for Australian cricket teams, men and women, to perform to their utmost ability. Between Pat and I, we take responsibility for that, and we've made a difficult decision today to move forward, and hopefully we'll get the response that we hope for and expect from this.
Ben. James, Ben Horn from AFL. Have you reviewed the decision to not send David Warner home after the other side of this happening again?
No, we haven't reviewed that. The decision was made through a code of behaviour hearing that was heard by a county court judge, and he made that the decision to suspend David for the period of time that he's been suspended.
James, Tim Abraham from Sky Sports News. Last week, Michael faced up to the question that Australia were in a total state of disarray given what happened with David Warner. And what do you say now about the state of cricket Australia with this latest announcement?
I think that people, as I said before, people will be surprised and perhaps shocked at the decision we've made, but I want to be very, very clear that we are not looking backwards here. We are looking forwards. We have made a decision on the eve of an Ashes series with the intent of seeing improved performance from the Australian cricket team. I'm very confident that under Darren Lehman and Michael Clark, the players as a group and the support staff around them will respond very positively to this.
As players, what do you think it's going to be like as the team try and get themselves together for the start of the Ashes campaign?
I think it's going to be good.
Charles Miranda from the Daily Telegraph. You've seen a lot of highs and lows in your career with your association with cricket, but how embarrassing is this for you personally, let alone for cricket fans? Last week you were trying to get cricket families along, and yet here's half the Australian cricket team out drinking to 2:30 in the morning. I mean, how embarrassing is this for you and also for the rest of us?
I don't think it's about me at all, but it is about Australian cricket fans and what they want and expect from Australian cricketers. And I think what it comes down to for me anyway is they want Australian cricketers and an Australian cricket team that they can be proud of. Performances that they can be proud of, and performances that lead to successful performance on the field. We're confident that the decisions that we've made tough as they might be, we'll see improved performance in the short and long term.
That's performance. What about off the field? I'm asking specifically about the off field, not their performance. We've had those lows for a long time. Off the field, though, we're constantly being disappointed. Who allows a team to drink, national team, to drink at 2:30 in the morning before games?
A key ingredient for a successful high-performing team is a culture of discipline and consistency of behaviour and accountability for performance. And those are the things that I believe are a very important foundation stone to a successful sporting team. I spoke about this a couple of weeks ago, and I think it was pretty clear that I was not happy or comfortable with the events after that match and those incidents. But I don't want to get caught talking about those specific things, because we've talked about that before, and this is a broader and bigger issue. And besides that, we're putting that behind us now.
James, first of all, will Mickey
have
his contract paid out?
Yep, Mickey's got a contract that has details of which are obviously private, but there's terms about that we need to meet, and we'll certainly meet all of our responsibilities to Mickey. As I said, Mickey is a good man. He has done his best. He's worked very, very hard. And unfortunately, it hasn't worked out for him or us in the end.
Okay. Andrew, you joined the tour in India, and you've also been around in the last week or so. Do you think Mickey's entitled to feel let down by his players that these cultural problems, continue? And also, can you comment on Shane Watson's role in the aftermath of the David Warner incident? It was reported that he spoke up about inconsistency in approach to...
Yeah, I won't go into individuals themselves, but pretty clearly we all have a responsibility. I think James reflected that on overall the discipline that was referred to earlier. And we have to take action, and that's been taken. But overall, I think you can sit here and reflect back and hope things are going to make a difference, or you can look forward. And I guess for us, that's what we're trying to do through today's process. And I think it's a good move, and I'm very positive about it.
So is he entitled to feel let down by the players?
Oh, look, I think, we've all got to take a role in this, and it's never an easy aspect. I was the one that spoke to Mickey, and I feel as though, what can I do better as well? So I think everybody's got to play their role and ask themselves what could they have done more. But at the same stage, we've also got to collectively unite, because it's a very big series coming up and a very big 6 months.
James Pat, can I ask you, in the light of recent events, have either of you considered your own positions? I mean, James in particular, you oversaw Mickey's appointment. I mean, how did this cause you to reflect on your own position within Cricket Australia?
Oh, not on my position. Certainly caused me to reflect on issues and performance-related matters that... as an organisation, we need to take responsibility for, and I guess that's why we're grasping the nettle today, and we're making a decision to make change, perhaps ahead of where public expectation might be, because we're not going to allow things to remain the same. Status quo is not good enough, and we need improved performance, improved accountability, and we expect to see that over the course of the coming months. I don't think there's any rot setting in here, but we've certainly had some issues. We haven't seen the improved performance that we would like on or off the field, and you don't have to look too far back to see that we didn't have a good tour of India, and we haven't performed well in the Champions Trophy. And quite frankly, those performances are not acceptable for Cricket Australia, Australian cricket, or Australian cricket fans.
James, Jackie McVeigh from Australia. What does Darren Lehman bring to the role that Mickey Arthur did, given that you've been saying how great a guide Mickey Arthur is? Why would Darren Lehman make a difference?
I think Darren is the sort of leader and coach that brings people around him. He keeps his messages very simple. And he makes it very clear to the individuals what he expects of them and the extent to which he believes. Now, I'm not saying that Mickey doesn't do that or hasn't done that, but I see that that Darren will be a force for change inside of the environment. And I think that, I wouldn't, Jacqueline, I wouldn't want to say that there's a silver bullet here by us just appointing Darren Lehman to do this job. The onus and responsibility is on the players and the support staff around them to respond to this appointment and to show how much it means to them playing cricket for Australia.
And
who do you replace Michael Carr as the selector? So Michael will stand down. The way that the selection panel will work over the course of this Ashes series and going forward is that Darren Lehman and the selector on duty, which is Rod Marsh, will be the selectors, where they need to consult more broadly in a selection sense. John Inverarity, as the national selector, will also have a vote if necessary. But obviously, Michael will be extensively consulted through that process of selection.
Second row.
Andy Wilson regarding, was Michael consulted in this decision? If not, when was he told and how was he reacting?
Yeah, look, so Michael, it wasn't consulted, but he was told, and it was, so yeah, and when was it, Saturday night, we first told him, so he had some time to consider and give us feedback, but no, it's very much been a management decision, a management process, and Michael hasn't been heavily involved.
And how has he reacted?
Oh, look, it came as as a shock. He had to consider it, but we've come down that route a couple of times. A couple of things consistently come out. They say, people are shocked. They question the timing, which we always we know and James dealt with. But ultimately, you've got to decide, is it the right decision? And that's got to be the last. That's got to be the overriding thing. And when you deal with that, that becomes the overriding answer.
Look, I think there is the ultimate responsibility for these things does come back to the coach. There's no doubt about that. But as a group, a team also needs to be working together. A high-performing team has all of the moving parts working in tandem and working in the right direction. And perhaps we haven't had that in the past. And as I said before, we're not suggesting here that Darren Lehman is the silver bullet that Australian cricket needs right now. But at the same time, we believe that the players will respond positively to Darren and they will take responsibility for their own performances and we will see significant improvement in performance over the coming months.
Dan.
James, the team clearly suffered from Ponting retiring and then Mike Hussey retiring so soon off the back of that. Darren, with his experience, has he then become sort of his coach, but he's also that surrogate senior player type figure who has that kind of respect.
Well, I think those of us that know Darren Lehman would know that how you've described that, Daniel, is very accurate. He's that sort of a guy. He's that sort of a leader. He's that sort of a cricket person. And I think that Mickey's job was made tougher by the departures, perhaps premature departures of Michael Hussey and Ricky Ponting. That's not an excuse. That's how it happened. But certainly Darren will have... He's close to the players. He knows a lot of them. A couple of them actually played with him. And I think that that's another reason why I have great confidence sitting here today in saying that I believe that the players will respond very positively under Darren.
Last question, Ben.
James, is Michael Pike's role as a selector impacting quite considerably on his unease and tension and the toxic kind of culture?
No. No, it wasn't. It was more about Michael having the time that he needed to prepare himself in a cricket sense, in a physical sense, and let's acknowledge the fact that he's had some injuries lately, but also the fact that he needs to spend time with the team, and particularly in this transition period where we've got a new coach, very important that both the coach and the captain have that time, and by not being a selector, even though he'll be consulted, he won't be required anywhere near as much as he has been.
Thank you.